welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all having an amazing day. So today we are actually doing something a little bit different. This was a request, a suggestion on my Discord server. So we are doing Lil Simsy's, is it called Shell Challenge or just Simsy's Challenge? Not entirely sure what she called it, but basically Kayla aka Lil Simsy built a shell, and she didn't put any windows on it or doors on it or paint or anything, and then she said basically just take the shell and do with it whatever you want. She did add some rules, so I'm just gonna read those out loud from her video, which I'll, by the way, link in the description down below in case you wanna check that out, but if you haven't already. But the rules in her description says, don't change any of my existing walls or add exterior walls. You can change wall height, and then you can add walls in the interior to create a floor plan. Additional fences, foundations, and flooring, etc. on the outside are permitted. No custom content, and you can move the shell around the lot or to other lots. So I think this was supposed to be on a 30 by 20, but I've moved it to a 40 by 30 just because I wanted to do something extra with the landscaping a little bit. So yeah, other than that, I think it's turned the same way she built it, although I'm not entirely sure, because I turned it around a couple of times because I was considering using the other, like the back side of the build as it is right now. I was considering using that one as the front, but I just kept having this picture of a terrace on the second floor, and I felt like that would fit the backyard a little bit better than putting it on the at the front yard. I don't know, it just made more sense to me, so I kept this this side of the build as the facade, and then the terrace is at the back of the build. Although they do have this little terrace here on the left side. So yeah, I was considering turning this into more of like kind of like a pastel spring inspired house. So we're using a lot of mints and also a lot of pinks for the exterior, a lot of flowers, and then maybe with some modern vibes, so big clean windows. But I also really wanted to decorate something really rustic. I was just in that kind of mood. So I turned this into a sort of, I want to say craftsman, like rustic kind of craftsman house. It's very rustic on the interior. I've just gone for all the woods, all the browns. I just went a little bit crazy. It's just, I really felt like just decorating something very rustic. So yeah, that is what I've done with the house. For the landscaping, I was trying to, like, in my mind, I wanted it to be a little bit crazier than it turned out. But we are using terrain tools a little bit, very subtle, not like, not something crazy, basically. It's very subtle, but there is use of terrain tools around this house, if that makes any sense. And then I also put in a pond. There is also a swing in the front yard, and then in the backyard there is a gazebo and also a pirate ship with a little bit of a play area for kids, because this house, I managed to fit 3 bedrooms into it because I didn't want to put any bedrooms on the ground floor. Plus, for some reason, Kayla put this little box in the middle of the house, and I did not know what to do with that. I ended up putting like an entrance to a basement there, but I forgot everything about the basement once I started doing the interior. So there's nothing going on in the basement. You can do whatever you want with the basement, basically, if you do download this house. When I put the basement there, I thought I would end up putting the laundry room down there, because in my old house we used to have the laundry machines and also the tumble dryer, whatever, all that stuff. It was in the basement, basically. So I figured it would be kind of fun to put it in the basement, but I just completely forgot everything about the freaking basement when I was doing the interior. So it's been uploaded to the gallery already. You can go download it there if you want to. And there is nothing going on in the basement. So you can, maybe you can put another bedroom down there if you want 4 bedrooms in this house. So yeah, but as of right now, there is room for 2 parents, also a teen, and 2 kids. And the 2 kids have a bigger bedroom than the teen, just because I wanted them to kind of have twin bedrooms. You know what I mean? Like, it's a big bedroom because it's for twins, so I thought that would be really cozy for whatever reason. So yeah, but I was definitely having some issues with the floor plan because of that box in the middle. Like, why would that be right there? I don't know. I was considering putting maybe a fireplace up against it or something like that, but I ended up just kind of ignoring it, to be honest. So the space behind it, or the space on actually both sides of it, is just hallway space, because I did not know what to do about that stupid box. I know she did that on purpose to just make it a little bit more difficult, which congratulations, you succeeded. I did not know what to do about that box, but anyways, as you can see, I also actually put in a sunroom, because I felt like one of the sides had to stick out a little bit when you look at the house from the front. So I ended up putting a lot of the very open windows on one of the sides, and it turned into a sunroom. And I put the dining area out there because I figured that would be really nice for the Sims family, or for the Sim family? Sims family? Whatever, you know what I mean. Living in this house. So they have a nice area out there where they can sit and eat together and just look over the nature or whatever. I did build this in Willow Creek, like I said before. It's on a 40 by 30. I don't know the price in the end, but I have a tendency to overclutter my builds, so it's probably not cheap. Just FYI, just a little bit of a heads up. Yeah, I was actually, it's quite funny because I got a comment the other day. I don't remember what video it was, and I think I might have deleted it just because I thought it was a little bit weird. I'm also not here to like drag someone in my voiceover, by the way, but I genuinely thought it was funny just looking back on it, because someone commented that I was a cheater because I used cheats to build, and I'm like, yes, because otherwise I could only build starter houses. I mean, what else are you gonna do? You can't build bigger houses if you are stuck with a 20,000 simoleon budget, you know? So I thought that was a little bit, weird. I thought it was a little bit funny too. But yeah, just in case you do play, you know, the game without cheats, you probably want to save up for all my houses, basically, not just this one. But anyways. So I was considering going for this kind of dark brown color for the walls, but I don't exactly know what it is with me and dark walls. I just don't like them. I feel like you're kind of stuck in a cave or something like that. Like, once you walk into a room and it's got dark flooring and also dark walls, it's just kind of like everything is just too enclosed. So I kind of tend to stick to either brighter colors or just white or gray. And I would have actually liked for a change to use that brown color, because I thought it went really well with the couches, as in the color of the couches, because they're this really nice purple color, and purple is one of my favorite colors, by the way, so whenever I get the opportunity to decorate with purple, I'm jumping right on that. So they're from Seasons, by the way, in case you are wondering. I think the same counts for the coffee table, but the inside tables are from Cats, or just the one inside table? I think there was just one is from Cats and Dogs. I feel like I've used quite a lot of stuff from both Seasons, Cats and Dogs, and also Get Together in this build. Possibly also Laundry Day, like the rugs, for example. I love the rugs from Laundry Day. They just fit in so well with more rustic interiors, so I always stick to those whenever I do rustic interiors. So yeah, of course I've been using those in this build as well. Anyways, I also just wanted to point out, even though I forgot to decorate the basement and put the laundry room down there, there is laundry in this house. So if you do play with laundry, you do have the opportunity to play with that in this house, and if you don't, you can just turn that into another kind of room, like a bathroom or something. I think there is a toilet and a sink in there as well. It's in the little room that's right next to the front door, because that's where I tend to put my laundry rooms these days. So I put it in the same spot as I usually do, just because it makes sense to me for whatever reason. I don't know why, honestly. I don't think I've ever been in a house where the laundry room was right next to the front door, but in my mind, it makes sense. So I'm gonna just stick to putting it there anyways. Actually, sometimes I also put it right next to the kitchen, because that makes sense to me. Or in the basement, although I don't often make basements in my builds. So I think mostly I put it by the front door, but sometimes I'll put it right next to the kitchen. Actually, I'm kind of sitting here now thinking, what did my floor plan look like? Did I put it next to the kitchen or did I put it next to the front door? I don't remember anymore. I think I may have confused myself a little bit. Hopefully it's fine. You'll see it at the end of the video anyways, because I always include floor plan pictures with grid on as well. So you got both without the grid and with grid, because that was a suggestion on my Discord server as well from some people playing on console. Because it makes it a little bit easier to rebuild houses, although this house is technically not built by me, I just decorated it. I don't know, this video is a little bit different from what I usually do, so I don't know how to say that, but anyways, yeah. We got the kitchen in here, so they just have this little corner slash square or something. It's right next to the sunroom, and it's also right next to the entrance to the basement, actually. It's a door you can see on the left side now and then. And yeah, I just used a lot of clutter in there. There's a lot of clutter. The counters, by the way, if you were wondering, are from Jungle Adventure. I use this quite often when I do more rustic interiors because they just have that kind of vibe to them. So I feel like they fit in very well when it comes to those kind of interiors. So yeah, this one was no exception. But anyways, we are moving on to the bedrooms on the second floor, and this one is for the parents. So again, we're decorating with a lot of brown. I remember getting a comment at some point. It's not because I'm like trying to drag people, by the way, my voiceovers. I'm not mentioning their names or anything. I just recalled while doing this voiceover because I got a comment at some point a while ago by now. From someone saying that they found it disgusting, yes, actually disgusting, that I use brown for my interiors. And honestly, I like it. I like brown for interiors. I feel like the room becomes a little bit cozier or whatever. Like, it's just, there's a lot of different colors that can make a room cozy. That's not what I'm saying. I'm not saying that brown is the only color that'll make a room cozy, but decorating the parents' room, for example, I just feel like it's very warm and cozy, basically. And cozy is a very important thing to me, as a Dane it is. So, yeah, I don't know. I like to decorate with brown now and then, and hopefully that is still okay with some of you guys. But, moving on. So this is the teens' bedroom, and their bed stands out a little bit compared to the other beds. I will admit to that. I just really liked it. I like that throw on the bed or whatever that is. I like the pattern on it. It's from Cats and Dogs, by the way. I have used the other Cats and Dogs bed quite often for grandparents' rooms because, again, the pattern on it just kind of reminds me of grandparents for some reason. So I just figured it would look really nice with the rustic vibes that we're going for. So yeah, I went with that bed in that swatch. Also because red is one of those colors that I find really cozy and also very fitting for rustic interiors, along with green, and I don't know why. It's just one of those things. But anyways, this room, I don't know if it's for a girl or a boy. I didn't really try to make it too gender specific. So it could be for either, in my opinion. I just wanted it to, first of all, be very rustic, like I said before, but I also kind of wanted the teen to be a little bit of a book nerd. So I ended up putting in both a desk, actually, but they also have books lying around the room, and they also have a bigger bookcase as well in there, so it could kind of look like they just really love books and they have a lot of them and they don't fully know how to put them back in their spot apparently because they just have them lying around the floor. So yeah. And then we're doing the bigger bathroom on the second floor. By the way, there's a total of 5 toilets in this house. So 4 bathrooms and then one room with the laundry machines and also a toilet and a sink. So a total of 5 toilets in this house. I know that's a little bit much, but it just kind of fit with the color scheme with the floor plan that I went for. So I think both the children have their own ensuite, and then also the parents do, and then the teen doesn't, but they can walk to the bigger bathroom, so I don't think they mind too much considering it is the bigger bathroom. They have a bathtub in there plus the shower. The other bathrooms only have a shower, I think, so. But I use the same items in all the bathrooms, basically, so I didn't include them. I actually think I did them right before I uploaded it to the gallery. So here on the channel, we like to postpone bathrooms or doing bathrooms for as long as possible because I just don't like bathrooms. So yeah, I did them right before uploading it to the gallery, but everything should be done. And now we've moved on to the children's bedroom. So it's for twins. They are the youngest of the bunch. And yeah, I do like how their bedroom turned out. I end up changing the walls in the end, I think, to another wallpaper. I also feel like these twins are very into animals, like they just like animals because they have a lot of animal stuff around the room. I've used both those posters that are from Parenthood. I also use these little pictures that are from my first pet stuff pack, don't come for me. But anyways, also use quite a lot of stuff from Kids Room stuff pack in there, like the furniture and stuff, and the rug is from Toddler stuff pack actually, so it's very red and orange and yellow in there, but it just keeps it all warm and stuff, like I just like that color combination as well. So yeah, and it was very quickly over with. But they also have some toys in the living room to play with as well, so I figured I wouldn't put too many toys in there. So it didn't take me too long to figure out the layout of their room and also to decorate it and stuff. Also, by the way, I completely forgot to say, but the teen does have their own terrace as well. It's a very small one, but they do have a little bit of a private space out there so they can sit and enjoy the weather on their own or whatever. And I just ended up putting a chair out there because, like I said before, the terrace is a little bit small, so I didn't fully know what I could fit on it, but they just have a chair. There is also a third terrace, just because apparently I am really into terraces these days, but yeah, whatever. So it's right here on the left side, as you can see, and I just put up a table and also two chairs on that one, and yeah, I don't know who's gonna use that, but it's there if they wanna use it. And also on the parents' terrace, I also put a table, three chairs and an easel, just because I figured it would be nice to stain out there and paint or something. You guys know I've done this many, many times before. I like to put terraces, no, other way around. I like to put easels on terraces just because the thought of a sim standing out there and looking over the nature and painting is really nice and soothing to me. But I know they don't actually look at the nature unless they do like a reference picture, then I suppose they do, but normally they wouldn't. But they have the opportunity to, at least if they want to. So yeah, I ended up putting an easel out there, even though I actually don't know what kind of careers the parents have. I didn't really think about it because this is a bit of a different kind of speed build. So I don't really have a background story for the family, but do let me know if you have an idea of like what kind of sims they are. Do let me know. I am definitely up for hearing you guys out on that. And as you can see with the pool that it's a fountain. I made it with a fountain tool. It looks like a dog's head. It's got like two ears on the top and then a mouth that's open on the right side. Can you guys not see that? I thought that was really funny when I did it and I didn't do it on purpose, but it looks like a dog's head. It definitely does. I might also just have dogs in my brain. It could be possibly because I'm obsessed with dogs. But I'm pretty sure that's a dog's head, I'm just saying. So for the landscaping, I just wanted the house to kind of be on elevated ground a little bit. And I was having some issues placing the stairs because there's this kind of bug with the stairs sometimes when you try to... I don't know how to explain that. I cut it out because it took me a while to place so it wouldn't like dip into the ground and stuff. I don't know what's wrong with the stairs when you play around with terrain tools. They just go a little bit mental now and then, it's fine. But I fixed it off cam just because it did take me quite a while and it got a little bit repetitive to watch, and I don't know, that's not super interesting, so I ended up just cutting it out of the video. But basically they just have this pathway leading up to the patio, and there's a staircase and then a staircase at the house as well. Very interesting. And then we got a pathway leading to the backyard as well, just because I like how that looks. And then we're also playing around with a lot of bushes, a few flowers here and there. I kind of stuck to yellow and white because I put yellow flowers on the build itself, so I wanted the landscaping to kind of match that a little bit for added coherence. Hopefully you get what I mean. And yeah, other than that, just a lot of greenery, a lot of rugs as well. I've also used some trees in the landscaping here and there around the house, and also some bigger trees, more like more bushy trees, if that makes bushy trees, that doesn't make any sense. Trees with more volume, let's put it like that, away from the house so you can still actually see the house, if you get what I mean. And yeah, I found this little bird bath and put it under this big tree over here, and I think that looks really nice. I end up putting this the swing from Seasons next to this tree, by the way. So I had to go back and adjust the terrain manipulation, because otherwise the swing would be kind of levitating in the air and I thought that would look a little bit weird. So I managed to fix it, and they had this little swing that I can use over under the tree. I figured it would be really cute for the kids to play together or something like that. The kids have actually been quite, what's it called, quite spoiled when it comes to the exterior, because they also have the pirate ship, but maybe the teen is more of like an indoorsy kind of type, so they just want to sit inside and read books or something like that, so maybe they don't mind too much. Maybe the toys or the pirate ship and also the swing has actually been there since the teen was a kid and they used to play on him a lot, I don't know. So I just think it looks really nice with like a swing in the front yard. It just screams family home to me for some reason, so yeah, they needed that in the front yard at least. And yeah, in this little gazebo, by the way, I do realize, yes, I just used exterior walls, but you can also create a gazebo by just using fencing. It's just a little bit faster to use exterior walls, so I just went with that solution. But I'm actually not using exterior walls, as you can see. I didn't add anything extra. I was also considering using walls to create a, what's it called, a garage at the front yard, but ended up deciding against it because I figured that would be against the rules a little bit. So I had to scrap that idea. But they do have a gazebo here in the backyard, and you can make that up, like I said before, you can make that up without, you can't make a gazebo without using walls, you can just use fencing instead, so it's completely fine. I did not cheat, I promise. I almost did though, because I started building because I did the backyard today, so I started building this house yesterday at some point, and then today when I started building again, I forgot the rules a little bit and I started building a tree house, and you can't do that because you can't use exterior walls. So I had to scrap that too. But I just kind of forgot for a second. I don't know, I didn't think about it at all because it's kind of a part of the landscaping, so you're not changing the house shell, but I don't fully know if the rules apply to like tree houses or greenhouses or anything like that. It just says don't use exterior walls, so I consider that to be cheating and ended up not going with a tree house is what it's called. So yeah, sadly, because I figured that would actually look really freaking cute in the backyard, because they have a huge tree down in this little slope that's on the left side, as you can see right here. I ended up putting this big tree, and I thought it would be really nice if they had a tree house in that tree, but unfortunately I don't want to break the rules. I want to just follow them like a good soldier or something. So yeah, we're not building a treehouse today, unfortunately. But I'm definitely going to build one in the next family home, because now I really want to build a treehouse. So that was the point. But I ended up putting the pirate ship under this tree, and then they also get a toy box and a plushie outside. And I know that's a little bit weird putting a plushie outside, but I just needed them to have this little play area next to the pirate ship, so I just kind of went with it. And then I framed it up with these small square bushes that are from Base Game. I also used this, it's supposed to be a gate, but I want to call it an archway made out of leaves or something. That's also from Base Game. So they have this little closed off area over here for the pirate ship and also the toy area or play area, whatever you want to call that. And I combined the leaf archway with I think it's a wedding arch, actually. I could be mistaken though, but if it isn't a wedding arch, I don't know if it still works, like your Sims can still get married under it. That would be a little bit weird, but at the same time also a little bit funny, so I don't know, extra bonus there if it does work. And if it is a wedding arch, I'm not entirely sure. So So, yeah, but they got this little closed-off area over there for the kids, and other than that, there's not a whole lot going on in the backyard. They just have this little closed-off area for the kids and also the gazebo with the grill area, so... But like I said before, I kind of put the house in a weird spot on the lot, so I didn't have a lot of backyard space to deal with or play around with or decorate or anything. So, also because I'm using terrain manipulation, and that takes up a lot of space too, because I personally like it when the terrain kind of blends in with the surrounding terrain, like around the lot, so we don't just have this sudden elevated ground, like a rectangle that's just a bit higher than the rest of the world, if that makes any sense. So, or the rest of the neighborhood, I should probably say. So I kind of wanted to blend in really nicely like that, and yeah, that takes up a lot of space too. Plus you don't want things to levitate either, so you can't really put them on hills or whatever. Hopefully you get what I mean. So other than that, we're just decorating the house a little bit with a couple of plants, and that should be about it. Maybe doing a little bit extra landscaping around the house, and yeah. So if you like my version of this challenge, you can download it off the gallery. My ID is EvelynYT, and you can also find it under the hashtag Evelyn or EvelynYT. Massive shout out to Lil Simsy if you don't know her already, which you probably do, but she is, the video is linked in the description down below, so definitely go check it out, and also try this challenge yourselves. It was actually a lot of fun, because you don't really have any control of the shape of the house itself, so a little bit restricting, but a lot of fun, so definitely recommend trying it out. And other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Remember to like and subscribe and all that good stuff if you did, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye-bye. Take me back to when we were kids and didn't care if we were acting stupid, cause all we had was us. If I close my eyes and think about us, I can see the person I know I should be. Cause honestly, I don't have no time to waste. I'm trying to come back to you, because now I see we were meant to be. Acting stupid, cause all we had was us. If I close my eyes and think about us, I can see the person I know I should be. Cause honestly, I don't have no time to waste. I'm trying to come back to you, because now I see